Our area's most beautiful properties deserve the finest realtors. Meeks Realty Group. We focus on buying and selling residential and commercial properties throughout the tri-state area. Contact Meeks Realty Group online at meeks.us or call 304-440-1101.
The views and opinions expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of 580 WCHS, its employees, or WVRC Media. From the studios of WVRC Media, the country, the United States of America, the state, West Virginia, the city, Charleston. This is the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live. And your host.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
He's kind of a big deal.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass, and I'm all out of bubblegum.
Dave Allen.
Hey, good Monday morning to you. Happy President. 5008, the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live comes to you from the Parmar Store Studio. If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon. Parmar, the official store of high school sports in West Virginia, and the official convenience store of Marshall University. And again, if there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, also brought to you by Thornhill Auto Group, including Thornhill GM Superstore. If you're in the market for a powerful, luxurious, and innovative truck, come check out the 2024 Chevy Silverado 1500 Crew Cab LTZ and High Country today. Find new roads to Thornhill GM Superstore. Click or come by thornhillgmsuperstore.com or on the road to total savings at Thornhill Motor Mile, US 119 in Chapmanville. It is President's Day, so let's do all we can today to preserve the memory of, I don't know, Martin Van Buren. I just made that up because I like to mention name drop random presidents. It is a holiday today, so many school systems, most are closed today. City halls, courthouses, no mail delivery, things of that nature. Depending on where you live, your garbage service may be interrupted. So just kind of, it's one of those strange holidays, you know, where it's like, okay, are you working or are you not? Like Christmas, when everybody knows that pretty much everybody's off. But anyway, coming up a little bit later on the show, we're going to spend some time talking about Special Education Day at the Capitol. That is happening Wednesday. Plus, it's official. We now have a new police chief in Charleston, Mayor Goodwin making that announcement Friday. Scott Dempsey will be the new chief. He had been acting as the interim chief. We'll get into that on the show. By the way, quick show note, Chief Dempsey will be on the show tomorrow. Plus, it was made official on Friday that Senator Manchin is not going to run for president. We're going to get into that coming up a little bit later on. Lots to cover this morning. And as always, your phone calls to text are welcome. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5850. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Want to go to the west side this morning. Naomi Bays is with the West Side Neighborhood Association of Charleston, and she joins us now. Naomi, good morning. Welcome to the show.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
I'm probably going to need you to speak up for me just a little bit because you got kind of a soft
voice.
Sorry about that. Well, that's all right.
Good morning anyway.
You sound good. You're good now. Tell us about your organization, the West Side Neighborhood Association. What's it all about?
So the West Side Neighborhood Association is neighborhoods. It's neighbors helping neighbors. They've been around since 1996. They've mostly just got started by helping each other do cleanups around the neighborhoods and do some beautification projects and just share information about events. And that's kind of what we're going to continue to do. But let me be on a bigger scale this
big
time
scale.
Around. Bigger
big,
scale.
Bigger,
yeah.
Bigger scale.
So, like I said, been around since 1996. I'm their first director that they've ever had.
Okay.
So I've been around now since the beginning of October, kind of working behind the scenes and doing some...
You know, you're not behind the scenes anymore, right?
Right. Right. You found me via Facebook.
I did.
No, I kind of did that deliberately. I wanted to work behind the scenes a little bit, tighten the organization up a little bit, you know, do some policies and procedures, make sure everything's up on the up and up, and then, you know, slowly make my debut and all the things that we're going to be doing.
What is the, I guess, the mission statement, as it were, for the Neighborhood Association of the West Side?
It is a lengthy one, and I will fully admit I have not
well, just,
memorized it.
No, you don't have to memorize it. Just give us the basic idea.
They see themselves as a convener for neighbors and organizations of the West Side. So they want to promote and assess and just amplify the things that are happening on the West Side. That's kind of how they see themselves. we will be having a strategic planning later this spring. So I'm excited for that to potentially have a much shorter mission statement than the one that we currently have.
Try to get it to two sentences anyway. How's that?
No, I'd like to have one sentence. Yeah. It's like two
Here's
and a half now.
I'm like, Here's what we do. Here's what we do. Yeah. I want to hear about good things going on the west side.
So we have a lot of good things. What we are planning to do, which I'm super excited for. So historically, they've always done cleanups. Right. And that was something that they had been doing for years. And then when the Goodwin administration came in, she kind of saw that what they were doing and kind of just took it citywide. So we are going to partner with the city for the one that they do in April. But then we're going to do three other large scale ones throughout the year. Mm-hmm. But while we're doing that, we're also going to encourage neighbors to love their block. So it's kind of like an adopt-a-block program. If you, six, eight of your neighbors get together and you do X amount of cleanups a year, you can get this permanent thing that will help your block. You know, and those things could be something along the lines of an artist-designed trash can or an artist-designed, like, permanent flower box or something like that. So those are the kind of the things that we're thinking about doing, and that idea is still kind of in flux.
Right. Talking again with Naomi Bays with the Westside Neighborhood Association of the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Pinnacle Consultants. Whether you're replacing a roof, remodeling a kitchen, or replacing a bathroom, to keep it safe and keep it legal, get with Pinnacle Consultants. They can inspect your site, collect samples, perform lab analysis, and provide results within about a week. Testing all renovations for mold, asbestos, and lead. It is the law, folks, in West Virginia. Visit PinnacleCorp.net for Pinnacle Consultants, because what you don't know can't hurt you. You talked about this strategic planning session that you've got coming up. Get into that a little bit further.
Well, most organizations should have a strategic plan. Like, what does it look like? What are you going to be doing in the next 3 to 5 years? So it just kind of is a guidepost for us, what we're going to do. We are currently looking for more board members. So if anybody out there is interested in joining our board, you can email me at westsideneighbor304@gmail.com, or just find us on Facebook or Instagram. Shoot me a DM like Dave did.
Now, what are you looking for in a board member?
We are looking for someone that is living, working, or has property on the west side, someone that has some time to give, and is really interested in moving it forward. There are some other little details that are available that we can send you the actual application form. We just want it to be, from the neighbors for the neighbors.
Okay, so it wouldn't necessarily, ideally you'd like to have either a business owner or a resident, but it could be somebody that spends a lot of time there is what you're saying. Like, if somebody, if that's what your job is, you own a business or whatever, but you don't necessarily live there, but you spend, like most of us do, working, you spend the majority of your day there, then those folks would be eligible to serve.
Absolutely.
As well.
We have a board member right now. She works for an organization on the west side, so she spends 8-10 hours a day helping the west side already, and she's a perfect fit for an organization because she just brings a different perspective. And she also has a link to that organization for us, and that works out really well for us.
Let's talk about the business climate on the west side. When we think about businesses in downtown Charleston, we think downtown proper, Capitol Street, whatever. But Charleston's a big old city by West Virginia standards anyway, and there's a thriving business community on the west side. Talk about that.
Absolutely. The west side is what we consider the west side is anything that's on the opposite side of the Elk River. So it includes Westmoreland, Bigley area, all of the flats, Edgewood, and into North Charleston to the Dunbar, city limits. So it's a huge area. Like, it is the biggest neighborhood. But yeah, it's thriving. There's all kinds of businesses down there. We have, the latest one I saw was a selfie museum.
I saw the,
We have two of those, actually.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, I know there's one, there's an Elk City, and there's actually one over on Patrick Street. So we have two of those. There's all kinds of restaurants. It's just, there's a lot of things going on there, and it just takes you going out and taking a good look at it.
It seemed to me that over the last couple of years, maybe in the time that I've been doing this show, which has been 4 years or maybe a little bit before that, that there seems to be a concerted effort on behalf of a lot of business people to want to locate businesses in that area. And it hasn't always been that way.
No, it has not. And my guess is that, rent's probably a little bit more affordable, and you might have a little bit more space You know, downtown and the East End are probably a little bit more restricted by, you know, how much space you need for what your business. And the West Side has a little bit more to offer on that.
What do you think the biggest conception, a misconception, I should say, misconception about the West Side is, in your opinion, Naomi?
What I think is the biggest misconception is that it's unsafe. And you know, while every city faces issues, it seems to me that it is a narrative that just keeps getting repeated and repeated. Not to say that there aren't safety issues. There are safety issues throughout the entire city. Just some of them don't get talked about as much. Some of them are not, you know, above the fold in the newspaper or, you know, the thing that gets talked about. But it is a vibrant community. Neighbors care about each other. They care. I mean, we saw that with the most recent gas and water line crisis. People came out and took care of one another. That is something that does not necessarily happen in other neighborhoods in the city.
Yeah, I've had a couple of city council folks on that represent that area, and they keep repeating that the West Side is the best side, kind of a thing. And that's the very thing that they talked about. And not always is it the people that you see with the pictures on Facebook, or not always what the media focuses on. There's a whole lot of things going on that don't get reported on, and that's okay, because a lot of times people aren't doing it for that reason.
Right. Like, I have a few board members that work behind the scenes, and I'd love to give them a little bit of love, but they do not want the spotlight whatsoever. But they, when I talk to them about what they're doing, I'm like, I am astounded by how much work they are doing in the community behind the scenes.
Again, let's kind of reiterate what the whole reason for the organization is, in case folks joined us late, the West Side Neighborhood Association. What do you have planned, and where can people learn more?
So the West Side Neighborhood Association, we are here to help plan major cleanups, help you love your block, do some beautification this coming year. If you want to find out more information, you can find us on Facebook and Instagram at West Side Neighborhood Association. We are working on a website. Hopefully that will be coming in the next month.
Cool. All right. Well, good stuff. You're doing a lot of good things, Brother Naomi. I appreciate you taking time out of your schedule to be here today. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Naomi Bay is again for the West Side Neighborhood Association of Charleston. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by General Hardware and Lumber of Winfield, from kitchens to paints, decks, straight framing wood, roofing, metal, anything else you'll need. You'll find it at General Hardware and Lumber of Winfield. Phone calls to the show, service of Biggly Piggly Wiggly. When shopping at your Biggly Piggly Wiggly, be sure to join their loyalty program. You can save big at the gas pumps and throughout the store with their electronic coupons and free gifts on Fridays just for stopping by. From farm to table, Biggly Piggly Wiggly, the best kept secret in Charleston. Texting services provided by Fruith Pharmacy. Find the perfect over-the-counter hearing aid of Fruith with NuvoMed hearing aids, plus Fruith makes it easier to transfer your prescription services to them. Fruith is your hometown family pharmacy. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk about Special Education Day happening under the dome this coming Wednesday. We're back after this from the Parmar Store Studio and the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Are you a physical therapy assistant and looking for an opportunity in orthopedics, wellness, and athletic care? If so, Generations Physical Therapy is offering flexible work hours and an upbeat atmosphere. With 7 convenient locations, Generations may have a job designed for you. Visit generationspt.com.
Hi, I'm David McCormick, owner of Omega Commercial Interiors. We'd like to thank you, West Virginia, for making us the number one office furniture and commercial interiors company in West Virginia. Remember, when you're looking for quality office furniture and space planning for healthcare, corporate offices, or even a private office, call us and buy local. Omega Commercial Interiors. We're a proud West Virginia company. Visit us online at OmegaCommercialInteriors.com in Morgantown and Charleston.
Do you support Donald Trump? Dwayne Duncan, the America First Republican running for Kanawha County Commission, does. Dwayne Duncan is a conservative that will defend our values. Dwayne Duncan is 100% pro-life and a member of the NRA. Dwayne Duncan wants more jobs, safer communities, and a better future for our families. Dwayne Duncan is not a career politician and will fight for all of us. Let's vote for Republican Dwayne Duncan for Kanawha County Commission.
Paid for by Dwayne Duncan for County Commission. Tori DeCubo, Treasurer. The road to your next ride starts at Members Choice WV during their limited time auto loan special.
At MCWV, you can get rates as low as 4.99% APR with terms up to 75 months. So whether you're looking to refinance your current loan or purchase a new vehicle, now's the time.
This special promotion won't last long, so take advantage of it today by applying at 201 Ohio Avenue in Charleston or visiting MCWV online at MembersChoiceWV.com.
Loans are subject to credit approval. Additional restrictions may apply.
.922, the Dave Allen Show and 580 Live, brought to you by Live Healthy West Virginia, presented by WVU Medicine. Live Healthy West Virginia tackles pressing health issues like heart disease, diabetes, Alzheimer's, and more. It's a podcast offering insights into medical breakthroughs and preventative care, featuring WVU Medicine's expert physicians aimed at fostering healthier lifestyles and beyond in the state. It's available, it's a valuable and available resource for all. Discover the latest episodes on WVMetroNews.com under the podcast menu and start your journey towards better health today. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Coming up this Wednesday, which, by the way, it's my wife's birthday, so please don't let me forget that. This Wednesday, the 21st, is Special Education Day at the Legislature. Jeni Burns-Reiser is here to talk about it.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
I'm very good. Thanks for having us on.
And we also have Rachel. Rachel, your last name again?
Rachel Brown.
Rachel Brown. And Jenny's pointing at herself.
Well, I'm telling her to get closer to the microphone. They might not be able. Don't be afraid of the microphone.
Yeah. Be afraid
this
of
is my
me.
First time.
Oh, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. So now you are a special education.
I'm
educator?
A curriculum specialist.
Curriculum specialist.
I help support 66 self-contained programs all throughout Kanawha County Schools, K through 12.
All right, Jenny, and what do you do?
I am a special educator for students with intellectual disabilities and autism. Okay. At South Charleston High School.
Okay. All right. How many students are we looking at there? Let's just take South Charleston High School, for example.
I have 13 students. Two of them come to me for three classes, and the rest of them I have for most of the day. Some of my students go out to what's called a work program. They go out into the community. They go to Thomas Hospital and Little Creek Country Club and the South Charleston Rec Center and get workplace skills. So they go there for a few hours every day, Monday through Friday. And then they come back to me for English and math.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Talk about what's going on Wednesday at the Capitol.
So Wednesday is, to my knowledge, the first ever Special Education Day at the Legislature. So we're going to have 300
students.
Yeah, 300 students from around the state coming in. To meet with our legislators, to advocate for stronger classrooms and what they need in our classrooms, and just to generally be seen.
Talk about the need for special educators in our classrooms in West Virginia.
Well, Rachel probably has a better mm-hmm. idea because she sees in Kanawha County, she touches all those classrooms.
Yes. So out of my 66 programs, about half of them are staffed with certified teachers. The other half are long-term subs or alternative certification candidates, which means they have a degree in something else other than education. And they are required to take classes and have a mentor. And luckily in our county, we have a really, really strong alternative certification program. But it would be like you with your four-year degree. We're mm-hmm. like, okay, you take these two tests and then we're throwing you in the classroom because that's where we're at. We are really, really struggling to find qualified teachers. And with the Third Grade Success Act, that has really decimated our aid population.
Now, why is that?
Well, now first grade this year in Kanawha County Schools has aides. Next year, second grade will have aides. And the following year, third grade will have aides. So that's three grades that they're going to have aides in all those classrooms. Well, our aides don't make a lot throughout the state, and it's an easier job. You know, in our classrooms, aides oftentimes have to deal with diapering. We have very, very challenging behaviors. We are the 1% of students, so we're not talked about very much. And our aides are responsible for tube feeding. There's so much lifting. And in first grade, you run a reading group and you help support the teacher, but you are not responsible for anything messy by any means or any challenging behaviors. And So unfortunately, a lot of my special education aides who may love their job have moved over to those first grade aide positions. Our pre-K classrooms are struggling as well because that is a very physical job, just like my classrooms.
Yeah. And ladies, from what I understand in doing a little research on this, many people involved in special education, if I get this wrong, you can jump in, you can tell me otherwise, would like to see something called self-contained classrooms. Now, what exactly are those?
Well, that would mean that the student spends most of his or her time in one classroom mm-hmm. without interacting with the general population.
Okay. Is that something that's needed or not so much? Or
I would like to see us move in an opposite direction.
Move in the opposite direction. See, I totally get the research wrong.
yes. To a more inclusive environment.
Okay.
And because in the self-contained setting, it's so hard to staff with qualified people. And our students deserve to be out with everybody else, not just in a classroom with the door shut. It's so easy to forget about them because they are the 1%. And oftentimes they're in a self-contained classroom okay. with the door shut.
And I can understand that completely. And I apologize for getting that wrong because I was reading and I was thinking, well, why? So I left out the word not, I guess, in there. Or not. That's not what you're looking for. But nonetheless, I mean, I completely understand as a non-educator and a non-parent, I completely understand what it is that you're saying here is that there can be, right or wrong, a stigma about this.
Mm-hmm.
And if putting these kids in areas where they're totally away from the other students can further that stigma, I would think.
Yes, and with people who are not qualified or mm-hmm. experienced or highly trained, it's not the best experience for anybody at all.
They're in a warm body into a classroom of students mm-hmm. who have challenging behaviors and specialized education needs is not a solution. Yeah. To long-term solution. It might be a short-term solution, but it's not a long-term solution. So Rachel and I are in alignment that we need to start looking at long-term solutions to this problem. When almost half of our classrooms are filled by folks, maybe even well-intentioned folks, mm-hmm. great people who want to work with this population of students, but we need a longer-term solution to incentivize working with our student population.
And is that the message that you're going to, one of the messages you'll be giving to the legislators that you meet with on Wednesday?
Yes, we are currently working with Senator Amy Grady, who has introduced a bill that would give.
Who's also a teacher,
who she's just introduced a bill that would give classroom teachers in self-contained classrooms a 10% raise and their aides a 5% raise as an incentive to choose these jobs. You know, right now, we get paid the same rate as any other special educator. But if you're given a choice between teaching students who have who might not have as many needs as a student who has severely challenging behaviors, might be considered a behavior disorder, or has toileting issues. Or, you know, in our case in high school, sometimes we have 250-pound men
mm-hmm.
Who are on the severe autism spectrum and, you know, who has challenging behaviors, who is entitled to that free, appropriate public education. And if you're someone who has a choice between working with that guy or, you know, one classroom of students who have, you know, mild learning disabilities.
Yeah, that you're helping to teach them to read, you know, yeah. compared to like last week I was covering a classroom and I'm working with a larger fellow and we use the term elope, took off and I'm trying to stand in front of the door so he doesn't leave the school, smacked straight across the face. And that's
You were physically?
Oh, yes. I've been kicked in the face. I've been bit. Some of our aides wear bite sleeves. One classroom I went to go cover, they handed me bite sleeves that looked like bear bags. I don't know if you're a hunter or seen them. I was normally used to Kevlar bite sleeves, but these bite sleeves were very thick. And those are behaviors we work on. And we expect our teachers and our aides to work with our behavior specialists to get through these. And our parents need us for this. But when you're talking about making the same amount of money or a first grade aide right now who makes just a tiny bit more money than a special ed aide, you're going to choose to go to first grade. Because it is traumatic.
Unless you're a knucklehead like me or you.
I know.
And we choose to be in these classrooms because we love them. But our job is to teach those folks to be a member of our community and to be able to be in places like the legislature and not want to take off and run.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so while these behaviors might be challenging, that's part of our job. Or part of our job is to deal with these challenging behaviors so that they can live, you know, as independently as possible.
The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Meeks Realty Group. As a locally owned real estate powerhouse, they specialize in residential and commercial properties. No property too big or too small for Meeks. With their team of the finest realtors in the business, Meeks Realty Group is your trusted partner in finding your dream home or that dream commercial investment. Call them today, 304-440-1101, or visit meeks.us. I want to talk about the calling that teachers have. You know, there are certain professions, and I've always said this, whether it's maybe the medical field or a teacher or whatever, that you feel, maybe a career in the military, where you feel police, emergency services, you feel that calling. And if you're going to be the successful teachers, no matter what grade, what level, whatever, have that calling. I would think, not to get too deep here, ladies, but I would think that to do the kind of teaching that you folks are doing in the schools, you really got to have that special calling.
Well, I feel like it's, yes, I think you do have to have a calling. But once you start working with these folks, I'm the one who was blessed, you know, mm-hmm. to be able to get to know my students and, be a part of their successes. For example, I had a parent call me this weekend and said, "You'll never know. Guess what? You know, such and such did today." And I said, "You know, he what?" And she was like, "He said I eat," and he's nonverbal. So, like, just these little micro successes, mm-hmm. I get to be a part of. Mm-hmm. Which is like a giant leap for mankind for this guy, you know, to be able to verbalize his need is a huge accomplishment. So, yeah, well, I think, you know, okay, it's a calling, yes, but then I guess 10 times blessed.
Yeah, you know. It's the most rewarding job that you will ever have. I mean, gosh, I have students that are now in high school, and when I see them, they leap into my arms. Jeni has one of my former students that I had for 5 years, and as soon as she saw me, she leapt into my arms. I made such a difference in her life and our family's lives, and teachers in self-contained settings and our aides, they become a member of people's families and of these students' families.
Yep. It's amazing work. I mean, it really is amazing work. Hats off to both of you and everyone who does this sort of work.
Yeah, it's, if we can't incentivize it through pay, let me tell you, you need to try it, because these guys can be super challenging and they can wear you out. But on the other side of it, you know, they come back to school and they tell you that they missed you. And, mm-hmm. you know, you get to see so much growth and, you know, throughout their lifetime. I get my students, I can have them until they're 21 years old. So they might come to me when they're 14, and then we're still, you know, seeing each other at 21. And hopefully I can see them through adulthood. My husband works with adults with disabilities. So, you know, we can really keep that care going for a really long time throughout their lives. And to be able to help them live independently, just simple things that we take for granted every day, like being able to drive or being able to go to the grocery store without being completely overstimulated and having a meltdown, or knowing how to have this conversation between us. That's something that we do organically, but some of our students literally do not know how to have an organic conversation or to make friends. So it's a really cool job.
And you'll have some students with you on Wednesday? You're going to bring some with you?
I'll have all my students with me.
Bringing the whole family.
The whole crew's coming.
The whole crew. And we'll have a whole bunch from our county as well. And I know.
And how many other educators do you plan on being there roughly? Do you have, I mean, will there be others? I mean, around
yes.
the state?
There's going to be a lot of educators coming with our students to help support them.
How many vendors do we have? We have a ton of vendors, too.
You know, and they keep popping up. So I want to say we have almost 20 vendors. We're going to have Abbott's Trucking outside. They have an autism truck, and there's going to be lots of fun things going
on. And we're going to have a rally.
Yeah, we're having a rally. Senator Tarr, Amy Grady, Mike Pushkin, and then I have...
Together?
They're all together. This is so great.
Yeah, I know. Look at that face.
It's a bipartisan issue. It's right. really yeah. been beautiful to be able to see this bipartisan effort, even if we don't get our bill passed, which I know we will because I'm an optimist. Mm-hmm. But to know that this is a bipartisan issue. Yeah. You know, education can be bipartisan.
And I said that kind of as a joke, but what people may or may not realize, and he's talked about it on the show, Senator Tarr has a special needs child.
Yes.
And he's talked about it on this show on numerous occasions. He's the child is an adult now. He's not a child. He's an adult now. But he's dealt with this, and that's great. I mean, because so many things, and you know, go ahead and blame the media. I'll blame myself a lot of times. We talk about, and I'm going to get into them after you guys are gone, some of these divisive issues. But so many things happen under the dome that are bipartisan, and you get a Mike Pushkin together with an Eric Tarr with an Amy Grady to make it happen.
Right. Right.
Yes. And the House did run a bill very similar to Senate Bill 680 as well. So everybody's on the same side. They're seeing the same issues that we're talking about today and not having enough staff. And if General Ed was staffed with half of our teachers in Gen Ed were not certified, things would be moving like 100 times faster.
Because
but we're the tiny 1%.
Yeah. And I would like to invite any general educator that would like to come into our classrooms and take the job. We are open armed right now.
Yeah, and I'd love to invite any member of the legislature to jump on their county sub list for our classrooms. There are no subs in our self-contained setting. Mm-hmm. It's very, very hard to take off work. Jeni, last week, the flu is going around really, really bad right now, and her aide was off, and there was nobody to come. There's no subs for her.
Yeah, I was all by myself, but I've got them. I got my kids on lockdown.
Well, it should be a great day Wednesday. And, of course, Hoppy will be live at the Capitol on Wednesday. He's there every Wednesday and Thursday in the AARP broadcast location. So go ahead and stop and get in touch with Hoppy and tell him you guys want to go on the show.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Guys, I appreciate you taking time out of your schedules to be here. Thanks a lot. Yeah, Rachel and Jeni, appreciate you being here. It is 22 minutes away from 10. Dave Allen Show and 580 Live, brought to you in part by Husson's Pizza. It's heart-shaped pizza time all month long. Get a 14-inch small heart-shaped pepperoni pizza, only $14.99. All for good for the entire month. Find your nearest location, hustonspizza.com. We're going to take a break. We're back after this from the Parmar Store Studio on The Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses care for your family.
Unsure you're ready for retirement? That's understandable. After all, you only retire once. Make the smart choice and call 4th Avenue Financial. If it deals with retirement planning, you can be confident they have the experience you need. Retire right with 4th Avenue Financial. Go to 4thAvenueFinancial.com or call 304-746-7977 to book your free introductory meeting today.
Securities offered through JW Cole Financial Incorporated, member FINRA SIPC. Advisory services offered through JW Cole Advisors Incorporated, JW Cole Financial, JW Cole Advisors, and 4th Avenue Financial are unaffiliated entities.
Attention high school basketball fans. If you want to see where your team ranks every week, check out the Thornhill Auto Group Power Index at WVMetroNews.com. Each week, Metro News will update the Power Index for all four classes. To find out where your favorite team ranks, go to WVMetroNews.com. Click on the High School Sports tab and then the Power Index. The Metro News Power Index is presented by Thornhill Auto Group. The road to total savings starts with Thornhill. Visit them on the Thornhill Motor Mile in Chapmanville and Logan.
Are you looking for a powerful, luxurious, and innovative truck? Hey, it's Sydney, inviting you to find new roads with Thornhill and check out the new 2024 Chevrolet Silverado 1500 Crew Cab LTZ and High Country at Thornhill GM Superstore on the Thornhill Motor Mile. Right now, you can get 1.9% APR for well-qualified buyers or $5,000 total value when you trade in an eligible vehicle. It's an opportunity to save big on the new Chevy truck that'll haul the winter blues away. Find new roads to Thornhill GM Superstore. Click or come by at ThornhillGMSuperstore.com or on the road to total savings. US 119 Chapmanville. All offers through GM Financial. See Thornhill for all details.
Vote Allie C. White for St. Albans Mayor on May 14th. Allie White is an experienced leader who is dedicated, focused, and active in St. Albans and invested in the community as a member of City Council, Yak Fest Committee, Chamber of Commerce, and much more. Allie C. White will be a full-time mayor because it's time for a change in St. Albans. Her plan is to make St. Albans safer and more desirable. Vote Allie C. White for mayor for a change. Paid for by the candidate.
Nineteen minutes away from 10, Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. If You're looking for a way to quit smoking or to lose weight. We have the ticket for you. It's tonight. Check out the Mark Patrick Seminars at Holiday Inn and Suites in South Charleston. Registration for the weight loss seminars at 5 with the seminar starting at 5:30. Registration for the stop smoking session at 7:30 with the session beginning at 8. The cost is $49. And you can register at markpatrickseminars.com. That's markpatrickseminars.com. Or they will take walk-ups. Dave Allen Show and 580 Live brought to you part by your hometown baseball team, the Charleston Dirty Birds. Get ready for the Mountaineers and the Thundering Herd back at Gomart Ballpark on Tuesday, March 12th. For ticket information, visit dirtybirdsbaseball.com or check out the Dirty Birds social media pages. And along those same lines, let me say thank you to everyone who joined myself, Steve Animal, and Shockley from our sister station, 98.7 Mountain Wild, Wonderful Classic Rock, and Rob Reel from another one of our sister stations, 96.1 Superstar Country KWS, for the Marshall Quarterback Club of Charleston's annual Valentine's Dinner and Dance presented by Astorg Audi. Happened this past Saturday night at Embassy Suites. We had a great time, to say the least. Not sure the Embassy Suites folks knew what hit them when the four of us walked in. Had a great time, raised a lot of money for the Big Green, and you know me, I bleed Kelly Green. And I just happened this time along to drag in Steve Animal and Shocklin Rob Reel along with me. I still at this moment don't know why Rob Reel showed up in a kilt. I can't quite understand that. He just kept telling me, oh, you're going to be surprised by what I wear. And he was right. We were. But thanks to everyone who came out of capacity crowd at Embassy Suites Saturday night. And thanks to everybody at Astorg of Charleston for making it all happen. Well, Hoppy is back. The GOAT, as Dave Wilson refers to him, he's back in the host chair following a week's vacation. That's coming up at 10:06 with Talkline. Top of the show, Senator Joe Manchin, who announced on Friday in somewhat of an impromptu speech at WVU that he would not be running for president. Now, I don't know that the announcement was such a surprise, but the timing of it was. Conventional wisdom would have thought he would have made a much bigger deal out of the announcement, but that's just the marketing person, I guess, coming out in me. Anyway, Senator Manchin will be Hoppy's first guest coming up at 10:06 this morning, explaining his decision not to run for president. Also on the show this morning, State Senator and candidate for Attorney General Mike Stewart. More of the latest WVU fraternity hazing bust. Chris Steierwalt, Brad McElhenney, Tony Caridi, and more coming up at 10:06. Mr. Caridi, of course, will be talking about the men's basketball team's loss to Baylor over the weekend and the women's team beating Oklahoma. It's talk line coming up at 10:06. Now, tomorrow on this show, Dr. Jason Sorens from the American Institute of Economic Research will be here. The new Charleston Police Chief, Scott Dempsey, we'll be stopping by the show tomorrow, as well as Republican State Party Chair, or Vice Chair, I should say, Tony Hodge. That is all coming up on tomorrow's show. In the heart of West Virginia, there exists a profound force that goes beyond the realm of sports, transcending limitations and fostering a sense of belonging. Talking about Special Olympics, a remarkable initiative showcasing the latest episode of West Virginia Enriched in collaboration with Huntington stands as a testament to the power of determination, unity, and unwavering support. See a video highlighting the Special Olympics at facebook.com/580WCHS. So on Friday, Mayor Goodwin made it official. Scott Dempsey is the new police chief in Charleston. He had been serving as the interim chief since last August. That announcement formally came again during a press conference Friday at City Hall. There had been 27 or so people that applied for the job, some of those currently serving as police officers in Charleston, some from other departments in the states, and some even from outside the state. And there were others there for the press conference from around the law enforcement community here in the Kanawha Valley. They showed up for support. Now, as for Chief Dempsey, he's been on the Charleston Police Department for 23 years. And again, he'd been serving as the interim chief since this past August after the previous chief, Tyke Hunt, resigned due to allegations of misconduct. His deputy chief will be Jason Webb, who is an 18-year veteran of the police force, and a reminder that both Chief Dempsey and Chief Deputy Webb will be on the show tomorrow. And I think it's a good move from the mayor. Following the Tyke Hunt stuff, I think the police department here in Charleston needed some stability. And I think bringing in someone from the outside, no matter how qualified he or she may have been, could could possibly have further driven a wedge within the department. And as always, I'm not sure, everyone's not going to be happy with the mayor's decision in a situation like this, because no one ever is. But Chief Dempsey seems to have the support of, from what I hear from the majority of the force, and our news team interviewed actually some of those folks on Friday. And I'll say this, that even some of the harshest critics of the mayor are applauding the decision. One of those that's on city council reached out to me even before the announcement was made on Friday and told me that they thought it was a good move by the mayor. So there you go. Again, we will have Chief and Deputy Chief again both on the show tomorrow. And if you want to read more about the appointment of Chief Dempsey, Kat Skelton has a complete story about the appointment posted now at WVMetroNews.com. Okay, along those same lines, maybe not everybody agrees, because the texter says all that buildup about a thorough hiring process and they hire internal should have gone to the outside. Says that. Well, I said not everybody agreed with it, and this texter was one of those, and that is certainly you're right. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you part by Brightways Insurance, the Mays agency of Taze Valley. Brightway offers up to $2 million. And life insurance from all the top carriers in about 10 minutes with a 95% approval rate and no medical exam. See them for all the details. Start a quote today at BrightwayMays.com. Well, the new chief gets to work on another shooting in Charleston. This one happening early Saturday morning. Happened at an apartment at the 200 Patrick Street location around 4 a.m. on Saturday morning. 35-year-old Terrence Wilder was the person shot, apparently in an argument between two guys. Story is they had a meeting or something at a downtown Charleston location and went back to an apartment, and it ended up with Mr. Wilder being shot. Police currently looking for a black man, 6'4", muscular guy wearing a black jacket and black jeans. Contact the police department if you know anything about it. Well, the library bill passed the House on Friday, House Bill 4654. And as we've discussed it on the show, it removes the protections for public libraries and librarians and school libraries from providing materials that could be considered to be obscene. Now, the vote went 85-12, and now HB 4654 will head to the Senate. So basically, if it passes the Senate and is signed by the governor, the people that are working at your library, your public library, your school library, whatever the case may be, could be charged with a felony or fined up to $25,000 or go to jail if what is contained in books is considered to be offensive. Now, the supporters of the bill say it's not a book ban. It just merely keeps these materials out of the hands of minors, because you know that's what kids do. They go to the library to look at porn because they can't find it anywhere else, you know, like on their phones, where they don't have to be bothered by words and such. Insert deep sigh here. Speaking of which, we now have House Bill 4867. That would require pornography websites. This is within the state of West Virginia. It would require pornography websites to provide some sort of digital identification or to comply with a commercial or a governmental age verification system of some sort to keep kids under 18 from accessing X-rated materials. Now, that passed 96-0 and will now go to the Senate. And that sound you hear, by the way, is your 13-year-old son laughing at you for thinking this is going to work, or could be coming from the X-rated industry laughing even harder if you think that that is going to work. But legislature, if it makes you feel better about yourself, so be it. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by Bridge Valley. If you're interested in improving your company's IT workforce, did you know that Ridge Valley offers custom-tailored IT training to bridge the skills gap. At Ridge Valley, you can train for little or no cost. With a 50-50 salary match, Ridge Valley can also supply skilled graduates and apprenticeships for your company. Visit bridgevalley.edu/apprenticeships today for more information. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. We're back after this from the Parmar Store Studio on the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses have been creating jobs in West Virginia since 1997.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon. You hear us say that a lot, but it's true. Wherever you may go, chances are you'll find a Parmar store there, offering everything you need to get you in and then back on the road as soon as possible. From gas to groceries and snacks and items for your house, we have it at Parmar stores. Download the app and sign up for the Parmar Rewards Card, too. West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, Maryland, Pennsylvania, and Virginia. If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Thrive with Five at the best community bank in the Kanawha Valley, Poca Valley Bank. Poca Valley Bank is now offering a certificate of deposit special, 10-month APY, annual percentage yield 5%. Take advantage of this great rate to grow your savings. For more information, stop by a Poca Valley Bank location today or call 844-782-2651. Poca Valley Bank, where relationships matter. Certain terms and conditions apply. Rates based on minimum annual percentage yield, subject to change without notice. Minimum deposit required of $10,000 of new money not currently on deposit with Poca Valley Bank to receive APY. Member FDIC.
Hello, I'm Teresa Howell, your Republican candidate for the House of Delegates to represent the Upper Kanawha Valley. We can work together to make a difference. I am your choice for faith, family, and freedom. I will work to defend our way of life and put West Virginia first. I have advocated for tax cuts, control government spending, and many other pro-growth policies. I appreciate your vote. Vote Teresa Howell for liberty, self-reliance, and prosperity. Vote Teresa Howell for a common-sense conservative. Vote Teresa Howell for America First.
Paid for by Teresa Howell for West Virginia.
.953 The Dave Allen Show and 580 Live is brought to you part by Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. Bigly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. I want to invite you to the West Virginia Fishing, Hunting, and Outdoor Sports Show. It is coming up in Morgantown at the Ruby Community Center, March 2nd and 3rd. Join us Saturday 10 to 7, Sunday 10 to 4. Over 100,000 square feet of nothing but the best of the outdoors. For more information, visit WVMetroNews.com or the social media sites of any of your favorite WVRC media stations or WV Outdoor Sports Show. Text says, can we please stop with this woke movement in regards to the library bill? I read the text during the break, and I'm not really sure where the texter is going with that. It just seems to me that, and I've said this before, as I'm a conservative Republican, but it seems like there are a lot of those, especially in Charleston, that want to spend more time in people's lives than less. And that's really not the hallmark of the conservative movement, in my humble opinion. Text says, ever wonder why the right wing is obsessed with kids, pornography, obscenity, groomers, and genitalia? It's a whole lot of projection, says a texter. House Bill 4299. Brad has a story about it at WVMetroNews.com. HB 4299 would allow teachers, administrators, or other school personnel to be designated as a school resource officer, meaning they, too, would be allowed to carry guns in schools if they choose to. It would not be required, but if they choose to. Of course, a teacher or staff could opt in or opt out if they wanted to do this and then have to go through all the proper channels. That is one of the bills that is being looked at as we speak. So again on Friday, Senator Manchin made it official. He will not be running for president. Again, he is scheduled to be Hoppy's first guest on Talkline coming up at 10:06 this morning. Hoppy back from vacation, and he'll be in the host chair in Morgantown coming up at 10:06. Senator Manchin is also the subject of Hoppy's commentary this morning. You can read that in case you may have missed it at WVMetroNews.com. Now, the senator says he doesn't want to be a deal breaker, so he's out before he was in. He was asked the question, he says, where can I do the most good? And the senator seems to think that it would be by going around the country and educating and just, I guess, talking to people who feel, his words here, who feel homeless and helpless. It's the words of the senator. With the current toxic environment in Washington. Remember, this is the guy who a couple of years ago, even in his political campaign ads, said Washington sucks. I don't think a lot of people would disagree with that. He referred to people feeling like they have to automatically hate the other side. And again, I would agree with that, too. And our current political climate, it seems that anybody that is of a different political party or a different political mindset is automatically seen as my enemy. And I saw an interview over the weekend with the daughter of Ronald Reagan, and I just caught bits and pieces of it, but she was talking about the friendship that Reagan had with Tip O'Neill back in the 1980s. Oh, how far we have gotten away from that. The announcement by Manchin, though, it seemed to me that the timing of it, as I said earlier in the show, seemed to be, it took a lot of people by surprise. Not necessarily the announcement, but the timing of it. Because as recently as Thursday, the senator was in Cleveland saying that if he did decide to run, he wouldn't rule out Mitt Romney or Rob Portman, the senator from Ohio, as a possible running mate. So it looks like both of those guys now will have to keep their day jobs. And I heard Hobby's commentary when I was driving in this morning. Again, you can read it at wvmetronews.com. I agree with 100% what Hobby said, is that Joe Manchin isn't going anywhere. I think he's still going to be around. He'll be part of the process. You know, and as far as Manchin goes, you know, he's been a part of public service in West Virginia for several decades as the legislature and as Secretary of State and as governor. Joe Manchin is very well spoken, and he's very pleasant to talk to and very media accessible. He always has been. And so I could see him making regular appearances on maybe the Sunday talk shows, or maybe on a CNN or Fox or MSNBC or as some have said, I could see him in a cabinet-level position, serving under either President Biden or Trump, whomever wins in November, maybe as an energy secretary or something to that effect. Just thinking out loud. Again, check out the interview with Hoppy coming up at 10:06 this morning. And a big props for Mike Nolte of Metro News for breaking the story on Friday, way ahead of all members of the national media. A couple quick texts says, finding a library for having an offensive book. Will they have a list of books that they'll be fined for? Just the woke, oh my blank hurts, it offends me movement. Only Republicans. Okay, hold on a second. All right. Only Republicans automatically hate the other side forever. It's been called a rhino because you disagree with Republican dogma, according to a texter. All right. We got to go. Hobby's coming up with Joe Manchin at 10:06. I will see you tomorrow. Till then, have fun and love somebody.
WCHSAM, 96.5 FM Charleston, and 104.5 Cross Lanes, a WVRC media station. We're proud to live here too.